before Nikki Blaze went on, we was waiting for Mrs. Jean Garvey. And she's returning. She's ready for you. But before I bring her or introduce her once again, listen, get a pen and a paper or pencil or crayon or marker, whatever you have to write this address down. www.change.org/clear Garvey's name. One more time, because I know you had to get a marker or a pencil or a pen something. change.org. Thank you for that. See, I was so excited. I just passed that part. .org/clear Garvey's name with an S. Okay, you go there right now, and we need your help to sign this petition to clear Marcus Garvey's name from the false accusation of criminal activities. And that is what Mrs. Jean Garvey is speaking to you all, to myself, to all of us about. So listen, learn, educate. As we were reminded earlier, we have to educate ourselves. We have to. So, Mrs. Garvey, I think we're ready for you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jean Garvey. I am delighted and honored to be in the company of friends, colleagues. You want me to stop? Other presenters and listeners worldwide, as we gather to celebrate what would have been the 131st birthday of our honored leader and my father-in-law, the Right Honorable Marcus Messiah. Oh, what would he be thinking today, watching us in the whirlwind? As we move forward with the issue of exoneration of his name, bear with me a little as we explore how we got from there to where we are today. And let me also thank the dedicated committee for inviting me to participate as we move forward. The exoneration of Marcus Messiah Garvey, human rights activist, champion for the liberation of peoples of African descent worldwide, greatest Pan-African leader ever, and founder of the Universal Negro Improvement Association and African Communities League, popularly known as the UNIA. Even though many of you may be aware of some information about Marcus Garvey, let me remind you of a little of the background and the genesis leading up to this action. Little more than 100 years ago, Marcus Garvey and the organization he founded, the UNIA and EmCee, assembled some 2,500 delegates from all over the world for the very first national chapters in the United States at that time, and more than 100 chapters worldwide, with more than 6 to 8 million followers. Think about that in 1920. Among some of the 54 resolutions passed at that convention were the establishment of the founding of a Pan-African nation without borders, complete with its own flag, which he gave them, the red, black, and green, a national anthem, the Universal Ethiopian Anthem, a holiday to celebrate the nation, popularly set at August 31st, a fleet of ships, the Black Star Line, to transport cargo and passengers between the African continent, the Caribbean, and the Americas. He also established the Negro Factories Corporation, a chain of grocery stores, a restaurant, millinaries, and a publishing house from which he published his paper, The Negro World. Just imagine this being done by a Black man in 1920. unheard of in that time. This demonstration of economic strength and power, backed by the African League, shocked the foundation of the British and French colonialism nations and racist systems of the United States of America. Well, needless to say, this did not sit well with colonial masters, and Marcus Garvey immediately became a marked man and the target for destruction by the US and other European nations. They even joined forces to prohibit Mr. Garvey from traveling to the African continent so he could not spread his philosophy of Garveyism as a transformational movement and freeing the minds of the Black populace. J. Edgar Hoover, then a young agent at the Bureau of Investigation, the precursor of the FBI, immediately started to find ways to curtail the success of such ambitious plans and to silence this outspoken activism and talk of Black nationalism. The organization was spied on, disrupted, and sabotaged. An attempt was made on Garvey's life. He was wounded by 4 bullets, but survived. His assailant was captured in the Liberty Hall headquarters in Harlem. That's where Mr. Garvey had his organization headquarters. And interestingly, the perpetrator was said to have committed suicide 24 hours later in police custody. Need we have to wonder about that narrative? The Bureau even hired its first Black FBI agent to spy on Garvey, a first for them. In 1923, the U.S. District Attorney of the Southern District of New York brought charges of conspiracy to commit mail fraud against Mr. Garvey. He was tried and convicted in 1925, with the only evidence being an empty envelope presented by a perjured witness who couldn't remember what was in the envelope. He served 2 years and 9 months in the federal penitentiary in Atlanta, Georgia. Back to his homeland of Jamaica in 19. Fast forward to a more current time. In 1987, the 2 Garvey children, including my husband, appeared before the House Judiciary Committee, chaired by Representative John Conyers at the time, and gave testimony along with the following historians: Doctors John Clark, Tony Martin, Robert Hill, and Judith Stein, all declaring Mr. Garvey's innocence. The Honorable Charles R. Rangel, now deceased, chairman of the House Ways and Means Committee, co-sponsored House resolutions annually for several years to exonerate Mr. Garvey, to no avail. As 2015, then President Barack Obama was petitioned to clear Garvey's name by issuing a posthumous pardon, declaring his innocence. The analysis of the trial, its legal and unjust proceedings, were well documented by the Washington-based law firm of Akin, Gump, Strauss, Hank, and Feld, LLP. It did not happen then, and President Obama left office with no response. Marcus Messiah Garvey, this iconic figure and champion for the liberation of peoples of African descent, deserves to have his good name cleared. Our very own Jamaican American representative in Congress, Representative Yvette Clark of the 9th Congressional District of New York, has now introduced House Resolution Bill 148 to the U.S. Congress, asking for the exoneration of the Right Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey, first national hero of Jamaica, to clear his good name and a confirm his innocence of crimes for which he was unjustly prosecuted and convicted. At this juncture, we will ask that all our listeners, friends, and participants write to their various congressional representatives, support House Resolution Bill number 148 in this upcoming session of the US Congress. Thank you so much in advance for your support. Remember also, the time has come. It is now. If not now, when? Let us never, ever, ever forget. We also have to thank Mayor Hazel Rogers and the beautiful mayor of the area right here in our own state of Florida. She is heading up our local committee here in Florida. And throughout this program, I was told that we would be flashing on the screen links where you can go and join the petition. Example, change.com. And there's another link I'd like for you to use, justice, the numeral 4, garvey.org. Let's get together and do our jobs. And from there on, after exoneration, let's move forward. Our next attempt will be reparations, which is more than overdue, the race of the Black people. Thank you so much. Have a great evening and a great invitation. Thanks.
Beautiful. Come on, snap it up. Snap it up. Determination. We're raising the spirit of Marcus Messiah Garvey. We will not let the internet disrupt us. We're going to keep it moving and we're going to keep sharing the information. Doesn't that sound familiar nowadays, though? It's the same thing that's continuously happening. And it's up to us. Unity. We got to come together. You know what I mean? If we don't come together, no one's going to do it for us. It's always been us. And you know, our race is very strong because we keep coming out on top regardless. So again, we want to say thank you to the one and only Mrs. Jean Garvey. And I have a correction to make, right? So the website, once again, you got your pencil, crayon, pen, marker, paper, fingers, www.change.org/clear Garvey's name, period, no .com. Okay, go on there, share it with your family, share it with your friends, share it with your community, because we got to sign this petition to clear the name of Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey. Indeed, 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 indeed. So I thank Mrs. Jean Garvey for sharing that information. We learn every day, and it's a blessing, right? Right? So what we're coming up to next, oh, you was clapping for me? Go ahead. Go ahead. Thank you. And I'm snapping for you for keeping up with us, right? That's what's up. So tonight, we are definitely giving out some community service awards, okay? So our very first one is going to go out to Michael R. Duncan. You don't know who that is, right? Great, because you're going to learn tonight. It's great to learn. Michael R. Duncan, after immigrating to the U.S. from the Caribbean island nation of Jamaica in 1978, Michael Duncan settled in Brooklyn, New York. Initially, Michael Duncan thought he was a Jamaican. Listen to this. But after reading the philosophy and opinions of Marcus Garvey at the age of 17, he realized that he was an African born in Jamaica. I'm an African born in America. That's what they told me. Mm-hmm. Afterwards, he attended Barack College of the City University of New York, graduating with a bachelor's degree in accounting. Now, by the 1990s, Mr. Duncan and his family moved to Southeast Queens, where he soon revitalized the Rosedale Soccer Club. He wanted to make a difference, so he got involved in helping the youth build character through sports, especially a team sport such as football, also otherwise called soccer. That makes sense, doesn't it? Soccer really is football because they use their feet and the American football use hand, but we'll come back to that. He was certain that if people act as a team, they can better their neighborhoods, respect each other, and improve their lot in life, all of which he learned from the teachings of Marcus Messiah Garvey. For the last 20 years, he has volunteered in the public school system, having been elected Parent Teacher Association President at PS 195, at Junior High School 231, and at Springfield's Garden High School. He is a mathematics, science, and the arts. He is a strong advocate of after-school program so that the teachings of mathematics, science, and the arts can be improved in schools in order for African melanated / black people to reclaim our stolen legacy. On August 19 now, 2016, Michael R. Duncan was elected President General of the Universal Negro Improvement Association, becoming the 10th successor to the UNIA founder, Marcus Messiah Garvey. The Universal Negro Improvement Association and African Communities League is a social, friendly, humanitarian, charitable, educational, institutional, constructive, and expansive society organized for the general upliftment of the black melanated African people of the world. You gotta snap that up. Like, that's works. And all that is on volunteer. Mr. Duncan is happily married to his wife, Sophia. They have 4 children. In addition to the many hats that Michael Duncan wears as President General of the UNIA, ACL, husband, father, business owner, community leader, and soccer club president, he is also the host of the community-focused radio show on Irie Jam Radio, WVIP 93.5 FM in New York. He's on from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. on Mondays and Tuesdays every week. He's on now, actually. Irie Jam Radio, WVIP 93.5 FM in New York. I hope you are logging in. Have that locked in, all right? Mr. Duncan uses this media as a platform to organize his community in order to address the conditions that affect them, whether it be policing, education, lack of wealth creation, housing, mass incarceration, or politics, to name a few of the issues that he speaks on. He also uses the program to rebuild the UNIA. So the community-focused radio show is... keynote address, which follows this Marcus Garvey Community Service Award to him from none other than the Rootz Foundation. Can you please make a harmonious sound wherever you are right now and give a shout out to UNIA President General Michael Duncan.
Are you hearing me? Okay. All right, brothers and sisters, thank you. It's an honor to be here. Rootz Extravaganza, I want to thank you so much. I couldn't have experienced a greater thing being honored on this day, the Earth Day of the Prophet, Marcus Messiah Garvey, to me, the greatest man that ever walked Earth. So I want to sincerely thank you for recognizing me with a Community Service Award through the works of doing the work of the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey. My name is Michael Duncan. I'm the 10th successor to the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey, 11th President General of the UNIA ACL. And I'm happy to serve in this position, to be able to serve African people all over the world. Brothers and sisters, it's a task by itself to be in those shoes that Marcus Garvey stood in, and I'm not able to fill them all by myself. But we want to continue to canonize the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey for what he has done. And especially on his birthday, we just can't thank him enough for everything he has done for us and our people. Mr. Garvey's vision, Africa for the African, served as an inspiration to many Black nationalists who brought on the fight for freedom and self-determination. Based on Mr. Garvey's guidance, if it were not for him, it wouldn't be possible. Imagine what Mr. Garvey meant to the African world here in these United States and other parts. Take for Harlem example, when he got there and he mentioned those few words, Black is beautiful. My brothers and sisters, they couldn't understand why this man was saying Black was beautiful when we were taught that our skin is actually a badge of shame and not a glorious symbol of national greatness. Mr. Garvey changed that paradigm. He taught us that, yes, our Black skin, our African skin with the melanin is a sign of national greatness. And as such, we as African people in these regions look up on our dark skin with a different sense of pride because Mr. Garvey. Brothers and sisters, Mr. Garvey created the UNIA, the Universal Negro Improvement Association, and African Communities League. And he couldn't give us anything better. With that, on August 13th, 1920, he gave us our flag, the red, the black, and the green. People often refer to the black flag as the Pan-Africanist flag, as the Black Nationalist flag, but it's actually the UNIA ACL flag created by Mr. Garvey. Brothers and sisters, historians have said to us, Martin Luther King have said to us, Malcolm X said it straight. He said, had it not been for Malcolm X, for Mr. Garvey, we wouldn't have seen a Malcolm X, or we wouldn't have seen a King. Mr. King said, special thanks and praise must be given to this African prophet, Marcus Garvey, who showed us the way of salvation. Historians tell us clear what he did, when he did it, and how he did it was impossible. It was not supposed to happen until 300 years from today. But we know that our ancestors and God himself was working with Mr. Garvey. Brothers and sisters, on a ship from London to Kingston in 1914, Mr. Garvey asked those prominent questions. Where's the Black man king? Where's his kingdom? Where are his people of high places? Where are our supermarkets? Mr. Garvey said, I could not find them. Therefore, I'm going to help you make them. We are happy that he made that decision. But brothers and sisters, we haven't carried on the baton that Mr. Garvey left prominently, because we still have to ask ourselves all these questions again. We work so much money, but we have to ask ourselves, where are our banks? We like our cultural food. We have to ask ourselves, where are our supermarkets? My brothers and sisters, we have to build them. Mr. Garvey left a legacy for us, and it's up to us if we want to continue to promote it, to build it. Brothers and sisters, we need to follow the philosophy of the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey. I must say to you that every word that comes out of my mouth are the same words that came out of Mr. Garvey's mouth. He left a black print for us that is foolproof that if we follow his black print, we are bound to have success as a people, and we will be able to build that base for future generations to stand on. So brothers and sisters, we're asking you for us to stand up and live like Mr. Garvey. Rootz Extravaganza, you are promoting education. culture among our people. We believe that if Garvey and Garveyism are taught in school, our children will be less likely to turn the guns on themselves. If Garvey and Garvey are taught in our school, our children will be more confident to know that they can own business, control their own business, and run their own business. We have two businesses that are totally inspired by the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey. All we did was to follow his black print. Here in New York City, 5 years ago, we created what was called the Restaurant Owners Corp. We call it the ROC. Through that, we got 190 people to invest $1.7 million where we created our own wholesale supermarket, where we are buying and selling our foods to ourselves. And how we created that, brothers and sisters, we got people to buy shares in this company, just like people bought in the Factory Workers Corp. Mr. Garvey had then, just like people bought into the Black Star Line Steamship Corp. In 1919, Mr. Garvey charged $5 per share, brothers and sisters. What we did with a 5% cost of living adjustment, those $5 then equals $600 today. And that's exactly what we charge our members to buy a share in this corporation. And I must say to you, currently today, we are issuing dividends and our investors are receiving dividends anywhere from $38 to $13,000. And that's following the principle of the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey. What else we have done? Mr. Garvey said it best. He said, let Africa be our guiding star. Let Africa be our stars of destiny. And as such, we have established a relationship with the people and the government of Liberia. We have created Liberty Farm, where we're planting fruits and vegetables. And in the next 3 years, we intend to occupy about 3,000 to 5,000 more acres of land to do agriculture, to be able to feed our people there and send some of the products here. Ultimately, within the next 2-3 years, we are looking to build that city Mr. Garvey spoke about in Liberia. Mr. Garvey said it best, what man has done, man can do, and we intend to do it. Time is of the essence, brothers and sisters. I don't know how much time I have. However, they brought up Mr. Garvey on trumped up charges. They had him in court in the 1920s in New York City. And while Mr. Garvey was defending himself, Mr. Garvey was getting the better of the U.S. attorney. Then the U.S. attorney turned around and addressed the jurors. His exact words were, are you going to let the tiger go? Are you going to let the tiger go? Brothers and sisters, they convicted Mr. Garvey. They sent him to prison. Before Mr. Garvey was locked up, some of our people asked him questions. They said, would you change the way you did things? Mr. Garvey said it clear. Mr. Garvey said, when I did what I did, I knew exactly what would happen to me. However, he said, men who are in earnest are unafraid of consequences. Therefore, we must do what we must do for our people, regardless of the consequences. Brothers and sisters, as I said, Mr. Garvey is the greatest man that ever walked earth. They locked up the prophet in the federal penitentiary in Atlanta, and Mr. Garvey was convinced that they were going to kill him in prison. So while being there, he wrote a letter and asked for that letter to be distributed to all Africans all over the world to ensure them that no matter what, he will be with them. So my brothers and sisters, I'd like for you to be patient with me as I bring Mr. Garvey words through that letter right here and right now. In that letter, Mr. Garvey said, after my enemies are satisfied, I shall come back to serve. He said, in life, I shall be the same, but in death, I shall be a terror to the foes of Black liberty. If death has power, count on me, the real Marcus Garvey. If I may come in a cyclone, pestilence, or as God would have me, don't you know I shall never desert you and make your enemies triumph over you? Would I not go to hell a million times for you? Would I not cry at the footstool of the Lord Omnipotent for you? Would I not walk the earth like the ghost of Macbeth for you? Brothers and sisters, then why be sad? Cheer up and be assured that if it takes a million years, the sins of our enemies shall visit the million generation of those who hinder and oppress us. If I die in Atlanta, my work then shall only begin, for I shall live in the spiritual to see the days of Africa's glory. Look for me in the whirlwind. Look for me in the storm. Look for me all around you, for with God, grace, and blessing, I shall rise again. When I am dead, wrap me in the mantle of the red, black, and green, for in the new life, I shall bring those slaves who have been killed in the Caribbean, North America, and Africa to aid us in the fight for freedom, liberty, and life. One God, one aim, one destiny, brothers and sisters. I thank the ancestors. I thank our gods for sending Marcus Garvey forth to show us the way to salvation. Brothers and sisters, we must join his ranks, join the movement that he created to ensure that Mr. Garvey is never dead. Our ancestors only die when we stop talking about them, when we stop canonizing them. Brothers and sisters, again, thank you for the award. I am honored to be honored tonight. Blessings to each and every one of you. Rootz Extravaganza, please continue to be a disciple. Please continue to be one of those cubs of the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey. I sincerely thank you.
So, yes. That was a powerful speech that he read for us by the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey. So I thank you and much respect to you and congratulations once again, Michael Duncan. You well deserve it. Our next performance, we want to give you some music vibes. The next performance I'm going to introduce to you is none other than A.J. Brown. He is a veteran soloist and he is the lead singer of Third World Band. Oh, you're going to learn it tonight if you don't know. AJ Brown, it's yours.
Jamaica's first national hero, Marcus Messiah Garvey, is beloved in the Caribbean, the Americas, and in Africa. Marcus Messiah Garvey is the godfather and patron of the cultural arts in Jamaica and the Harlem Renaissance in the USA. This is the 134th anniversary of his birth in St. Anne's, Jamaica, and I am very honored and privileged and humbled to be part of this celebration. I'm AJ Brown.
Just some little words. To help you make you know yourself. Yeah. Listen. A nation without any history is like a tree without roots. That kind of tree can never bear no fruit. No. Before you dance abroad, you've got to learn to dance a yard. Self-empowerment don't even cost a cent. Hey. Just some little words of wisdom. Alright, to lead your mind to freedom. Oh hey, hey, yeah, just some little words of wisdom. Hey, to lead your mind to freedom. Listen up. Don't watch and expect any handouts. You can do for yourself. Just put your shoulder to the wheel and I'm sure you will help yourself. Hey. Learn a little more about your history so you can better know yourself. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. Hey. Just some little words of wisdom. Alright. To lead your minds to freedom. Freedom of speech, yeah. Just some little words of wisdom. Freedom of expression, yeah. To lead your minds to freedom. Listen. Just some words. Some words. To lead your minds to freedom. Freedom of expression, yeah. And in all this, remember the Father, the one who gave you life. Remember, without him, you can never, never survive. No. He is your rock and your fortress in any time of need. Remember, when you tried, he would be your guiding light. Hey. Just some little words of wisdom. Oh, yes. To lead your minds to freedom. Oh, yeah. Just some little words of wisdom. Hey. To lead your minds to freedom. Just some words.
Just some words.
Just some words. Hey. A nation without any history is like a tree without roots. That kind of tree can never bear no fruit. No. Before you dance abroad, you've got to learn to dance a yard. Self-empowerment don't even cost a cent. Hey. Just some little words of wisdom. Oh, yes. To lead your minds to freedom. Oh, yeah. Just some little words of wisdom. Well, to lead your minds to freedom. Open your minds. So you can better know yourself, yeah. Open your minds. So you can better know yourself. Open your minds. So you can better know yourself. See that? Yeah.
Amazing, amazing. That was AJ Brown, our veteran soloist and the lead singer of Third World Band. So once again, snap it up, giving us the message, the words of wisdom. Thank you.